I think I'm inspired by a lot of short story writers, but right at the very top is definitely John Cheever. He wrote a vast amount of short stories, every one brilliant in its own way. The story The Swimmer, which is about this guy called Neddy Merrill, who basically swims across these suburban swimming pools to his own house, and finds his house locked up and abandoned. The character himself, who seemed sort of both vibrant and alive and empty at the same time. And Neddy Merrill in The Swimmer is as tragic a figure as, you know, King Lear. I wrote a sort of song. It was a kind of a programmed song using a lot of programming. It was called The Skyrider Stories. And I was really lucky because I came across a little excerpt of Cheever actually reading from The Swimmer. And it was just fantastic to put that into the song.
He went through a hedge that separated the Westerhouses land from the Grahams. Walked under some flowering apple trees, past the shed that housed their pump and filter, and came out at the Grahams' pool. "Why, Neddy," Mrs. Graham said, "what a marvellous surprise. I've been trying to get you on the phone all morning. Here, let me get you a drink." He saw then, like any explorer, that the hospitable customs and traditions of the natives would have to be handled with a diplomacy. And if he was ever going to reach his destination, he did not want to mystify or seem rude to the Grahams, nor did he have the time to linger there. He swam the length of their pool and joined them in the sun and was rescued a few minutes later by the arrival of two carloads of friends. During the uproarious reunions, he was able to slip away. He went down by the front of the Grahams' house, stepped over a thorny hedge, and crossed a vacant lot to the Hammers. Mrs. Hammer, looking up from her roses, saw him swim by, although she wasn't quite sure who it was. The Lears heard him splashing past the open windows of their living room. The Howlands and the Crosscups were away. After leaving the Howlands, he crossed Ditmars Street and started for the bunkers, where he could hear, even at that distance, the noise of a party, noise of a party, noise of a party, noise of a party, noise of a party.